The beauty thing is I don't have to do any kit building whatsoever. I am completely plug and play with this van. It's literally, I just have to hook up the wires to my DC block, which is in there, goes into that, bada bing, bada boom, I got myself an electrical system. I'm starting off this vlog in not the greatest of moods. As you guys can see behind me, I'm at Ace Hardware. This is my daily driver and truck. I just picked this up. This is some half inch Rich Light. Really excited about it. It's my countertop. It's beautiful. Thank you to Overland Van Projects for hooking me up. That's Dustin. Why am I in a sour mood right now? It's because I locked my keys in my truck. The worst part about all this, AAA will not come out to my service my vehicle because I just picked this truck up and I have temporary tags on it until I go to the DMV. They don't service vehicles that have temporary tags on it. So AAA, I'm calling you out right now. I pay for this service and you can't even help me. So now I'm waiting for a locksmith to come out and break into my vehicle. I also called the glass company while I was been waiting, and I've debated on breaking my glass, either this window or this window. This window's cheaper, by the way. To break the glass and get in is about $2.25. That's $225. And the back windows are about $250, $270. So now Miles from Light Harvest Solar is gonna come up and keep me company. And we're gonna try to break into it ourselves. All right, everybody, I am at the van now. I got my keys back out of my van. Miles actually kept me company, but it actually worked out. This was a really good segue. Thanks. I paid before he broke into my truck. The truck is right there, everybody. I paid him before he got into the truck, and I was like, how confident? He's like, I've been doing this 7 years. And I'm like, all right, this guy's my kind of guy.
It took him about 4 minutes.
I don't even think it took that long. Anyways, Miles is here right now because this is the Light Harvest Solar Aspen, which is gonna be my entire power system. This thing is a beauty. I've used it many times, have showed it off on my channel. We had a Brava oven cook a steak off of this. 2000 watt inverter. It's about 170 amp hours, give or take.
Give or take,
yeah. I got a 380 watt panel, yeah. Also from Light Harvest Solar, that I did a video on. And we're about to hook up alternator charging. When I first talked about this with Miles, you can plug it into a cigarette lighter port.
You can, but it takes up your solar input. So you can't do both solar and a cigarette lighter port. You can do one or the other.
Not only that, the cigarette lighter port only gives off like what?
It's like 100 watts, 110 watts.
Right. You want to show us here. You show us what we're talking about now.
We've got two inputs here. Make it so you can charge with solar and alternator charging at the same time. So the way we do that is this is your charger. You can see it's just got a 120 volt alternating current plug for your house, and you plug it right in. So right there. So you can plug it in your house and you can charge it. And this would typically be called your shore power charging. The way that we set this up so you can charge with alternator while it's got solar going too is basically we hook up an inverter to your alternator. So this is a 120 volt AC inverter. And basically it's just gonna literally plug in right here. That goes to your inverter or your alternator, I'm sorry, of your car. Energizes this, gives you 120 volt AC, and then it goes and charges at something like 500 watts.
Yeah, I did a video with John recently, and I'm gonna turn this around now. Sure. I did a video with John recently, and we actually showed that in action. We hooked it up to one of your batteries, and we just used the battery as the, you know, as the alternator. Right, and it was charging, I think it charged at like 400 watts.
Give or take.
Something like that?
Between 4 and 5, uh-huh.
Between 4, it was like 460, yeah. Which means that will charge how fast? From dead.
Theoretically, from dead, you know, three to four hours, let's just say.
So you take a drive from LA to Las Vegas, that thing will be fully charged, no problem.
And that's at night. If it's got solar too, you'll have another 380. So you will have the capability to be somewhere into like, you know, I don't know.
700 range.
Let's say 450 plus 380.
Yeah.
So 800, a little over 800.
A little
watts,
over 800 watts.
Which means a couple hours.
Couple hours, you know, which is fantastic.
Yeah, super good, especially if you're living in it because you got to cook breakfast and then you want it back up by the time you want to cook lunch and then back up by the time you want to cook dinner.
Which, even if you did, like, I remember I ran the Brava for like 20 something minutes and it depleted at 20%.
Sure.
But that's like 2,000 watts that we were running for a constant 20-25 minutes.
Sure.
So that is a lot of power, and we only depleted 20% of that battery, which isn't bad at all.
No, no, it's great.
It's great. Sure. I just wanted to show that we're going to be hooking up alternate. I'm hooking up my power, actually. Super easy to hook up.
Right,
because right. We can show that too if you want.
Real simple. This is your, we got a 25 volt DC 12 volt output. I guess it's actually 13.6 regulated, but there, that's your 12 volt output. And then it's just gonna go.
You guys can see it over there.
Into your distribution, and that's gonna run your lights and things.
You sell that, it's called the Phoenix.
So into Victron Phoenix, yeah.
Victron Phoenix, but you sell that. So for people that have the Aspen or the EP500 that you also sell,
sure.
You can technically charge those products up with that guy mm-hmm. from your alternator truck.
Yeah, I'll have to check the EP500, I haven't done it yet.
John and I did.
I think it's the same charger. And it's a matter of matching the power that takes in with the power that the Victron puts out.
The beauty thing is I don't have to do any kit building whatsoever.
Right.
I am completely plug and play with this van. It's literally, I just have to hook up the wires to my DC block, which is in there, goes into that, bada bing, bada boom. I got myself an electrical system. 2-year warranty on this?
2-year warranty, uh-huh.
Awesome. I haven't wired anything up yet. I'm gonna wire up my fan just to make sure it all kind of works properly. And I'm gonna fit the Phoenix into place. Yeah. The Phoenix is gonna live behind in that little cabinetry, and we're gonna be good to go. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I think it'll work out good.
You may be able to hear a fan in the background. You probably can't see it running, but it is on running right now. Yeehaw, we got power. This is what I was talking about. This is super easy, it's super simple. The DC fuse block is plugged in, and this wire is linked up to the Aspen, which I'll show you in a second. This is the fan wire, really simple and easy. And then it's plugged into this, which is, this is locked. This isn't going anywhere. This with vibration won't go anywhere. And right now my fan is pulling, probably can't see it. 6 watts, 5 watts, 8 watts. As you can see, it's a very low draw on it. Everything in here is going to be DC powered. So that's why I have a DC fuse block right there. Very easy plug and play system. Boom, 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 done and done. So I'm going to have lights hooked up to that. Water pump, refrigerator will be on. Just all that good stuff. As you guys can tell now, I got power. That's all you really need with these all-in-one systems. For people that are on a budget, I think it's perfect for people that, do not want to mess around with electrical or building their own system or something like that. And once Light Harvest Solar does the extra battery system, they've done it, but they're fine tuning some things, and we're going to get to that. We talked about a minute ago, you can easily charge it up with this thing right here, which is the inverter that plugs into my battery of the van itself. All right, let's finish out this video strong, and hopefully I can get everything else wired up, and I'll actually finish out the video of me talking about this, because last video I did not have this in there. So all right guys, I don't know how much I got left in the tank, running on fumes here the end of the day on Saturday. Put this video out on Sunday morning, hopefully, if I go home and edit this up, take you through what I've done I think since the last video. My apologies for not doing time lapses of everything, but I have just been putting my head down and just going, just completely just trying to get as much done as quickly as possible. Get some more light over here. And the reason for that is because I'm trying to make it to Schoolypalooza, a massive gathering for nomads, the end of this month, at the end of January. So I'm trying to get down there because that's where also my dog will be, my puppy. So what have I been doing? Well, you see the slats that are behind me. I did those. And I have this galley that I put in behind me as well. And the heater you guys already know about, but that's gonna be fun too. So it's kind of a little bit of a disaster zone in here right now. Natalie just came back. Natalie is the person that owns the bus right next to me. She's also a DIYer that leases space from here as well. Her dog Wilma is so cute. The end of the day. This is why I recorded the beginning of days. I gotta start doing that again. Slats. Slats. Look at this. This is Wilma. This is Natalie's dog. Hey, honey. Hi, sweetie. Hi. Oh, thank you so much. Okay, go lay down. Go lay down. She's the best.
can't wait to go get my dog. Anyway, so the slat, so the reason I wanted to do something a little different, now I didn't obviously come up with this. This is a very obvious, a lot of people do this. There's the reason why there's lines in a van is to accentuate or elongate a space. So like, you know, ceilings are done with lines this way to kind of elongate a space. Same thing here, this, you know, the walls would be done the same way. So obviously I didn't invent slatted looks, like that's obvious. I wanted to do something a little different with the lighting. The lighting I'm going to be doing is really cool. There's lighting up here that comes over. When I plug it all in, you guys will see that. And then this board right here has lighting actually coming down on the counter. So that'll be on a separate switch. And then on my passenger side will be a whole nother, you know, strip to come up on the top. Now, what I'm doing really cool is I'm going to have the slats will continue to as like a partition right here, and that'll happen way later when I put the counters in and everything else. I actually have no idea if I showed the refrigerator box. So refrigerator box. I forgot I had something on the top of the fridge and it just kind of went off the back there. We'll see. 250-pound straw slides on this bad boy. And it's beautiful. I love that thing. You know what's funny? In my first design, the refrigerator was actually where the sink is. And I changed it up when I started building all my cabinetry. Allow for change. Draw down in the bottom. I'm using a Baltic birch, so you can see the end grain there. You know, it's really pretty. That's Natalie's bus, by the way. Okay. Wait until you guys see what I'm going to do. Where I'm sitting right now is a swivel seat. Wait until you guys see. A lot of people have asked me where I got the swivel seat. Honestly, I just like did a search on Ford Econoline swivel seats. Every van is different when it comes to swivels, by the way. So if you have a Sprinter, you have to order a Sprinter swivel seat. Factory is always the best. I used Alpine in my last van. Thing with Alpine, I didn't really like their customer service. And then there's another one that everybody uses. Starts with an S. I forget what the name is. I wanted this swivel seat for the reason of like, this is going to be my work zone. I'm getting my window covers next week. I'm really excited about that, but this needed to be a section for me to be part of the living space. When I do park for the night or wherever I'm at, I'm going to make those window covers be, you know, they're going to be blackout. They're going to be great. They're from Van Made Gear. I can't wait to get them. Simon is a friend of mine. So I will bring the camera there next week when I show that off. Yeah, I got some really cool things planned for this galley, as well as my lagoon's going to be sitting right here, and it's going to be come over where I'm sitting right now. So it's going to be a lot of fun, guys. I can't wait to show the rest off. I have no idea what I'm saying or doing. I think I'm just too tired to kind of go further here. What do you guys think though? You think it's coming along well? How about this one? Do you guys think I'm actually still going to get it done by the like, that's the thing. If I put my head down and I actually just focus and go and build, and I can get a lot done in a little amount of time. Let's see how far I can get next week. Yeah, she wants to do a trick on camera. Is that what you want to do?
Okay. Can you shake? No, shake. Shake with your other hand. Okay, wait. Okay.
Aww.
She'll get it.
It was all there right up into the end. All right, guys, I'm gonna save the rest for the next video. Let me know what you guys think. What I was talking about over here is the slats that are on my driver's side is gonna match this side, but instead of them cutting off at the bed area, they're gonna actually continue on the entire length. So the sliding door is gonna have slats all the way down, and I'm gonna make a like they're not gonna. They're gonna be like staggered at the end, you know, and then the top one will have a light going all the way down. So until next time, guys, I'll see you guys later. I could run through the fire, I could come get the night.